Hello, today we're gonna talk about Lagrange points. These are points in space that are known for their special purpose in real space. At these locations, all forces, gravitational and centrifugal, are balanced out. Smaller objects stay there in relation to bodies with large masses like planets. They usually contain asteroid fields, nebulas, and in Star Citizen, they also host our mining stations. These Lagrange points are named after Joseph Louis Lagrange, an Italian-French mathematician that discovered predicted these points in the 18th century. The diagram you see here was originally created for a showcase with the James Webb Space Telescope, which is located at the Lagrange 2 point of Earth and Sun. The reason why L2 or Lagrange 2 is to keep its instruments perpetually shaded. Now, let's get back to topic and check out where these points are. So, let's start with the Sun, then we take the planet, and now the first Lagrange point is located at this spot. It's between the Sun and the planet, but it's closer located to the planet. The second Lagrange point is directly behind the planet. And the third Lagrange point is on the opposite direction of the Sun or star. And we have also two other Lagrange points, L4 and L5. If you always get confused about these two, L4 is located in the direction in which the planet orbits, like before, and Lagrange 5 is located behind. So in this case, the planet rotates to the right from our view, and if we take a look at the map from the previous video, we will see that Crusader and Hurston are located on the opposite direction of the star. Therefore, L3 or Lagrange 3 of one planet will be next to the other planet. As bounty hunter or mission runner, you might want to look for missions located at L1, L2 and L3 from the opposite pair to keep travel times short. With this knowledge gained, I will leave you for today and end this video. Have a good time in the verse.